introducing our Northeast boys under the
And then out here on Thursday.
That's like right.
As far as the race itself, how did it play out for you? How'd you feel?
I felt pretty good the first lap. The hill was a bit difficult, but I kind of recovered quickly. And although the start was really fast, I thought the pace was comfortable enough for me that I could go a little faster and push myself on that second lap. And that's what I hoped to do. I just wanted to stick with the front pack. And once I got over that hill, my goal was just to get to the line as fast as possible.
This is a strength course, second hill, second time around always is key. You're a strength runner. How much did you like this course today?
I enjoyed it a lot. I thought the hill was definitely difficult, and I heard it was a hard course. But I think the race in Portugal also prepared for me well for that, since that course was pretty much all hills. So I think I was ready for that, and I'm glad that I was able to make it through that hill the second time.
During the week, physically, did you have any doubts because of the long travel and so forth?
A little bit, but actually mostly that I've been racing a lot, and all these races were definitely super hard for me, and I knew that I felt a little bit of fatigue, like my legs weren't as fresh as they could be, but I just decided to forget about it and just race.
I may have missed it earlier. What was your approach coming into the race, your strategy?
My strategy was just to stick with the front pack for the first lap and actually for most of the race and just like give it everything at the end. I knew that if I went conservative the first lap, I might not be able to catch up on the second lap, so I just decided to go out fast.
First lap was done. How did you feel at that point in time, and did you sense how the others were doing? Did you have any feel?
I thought that, I think I realized that Kaylin was slowing down a little bit on the hill, so not on the big hill, but like on these hills, and I thought that I could try to get ahead of her, but I also heard the runners behind me, so I knew that we were still a big pack. I was a little worried about that, but I knew that I'm running with amazing girls around me, so I definitely had to carry her home.
The senior from Westmoreland Senior High School in New Jersey got a PR of 908 for 3200 on the track.
I think it was a bit of an advantage, yes, because we race each other a lot, so I know how they race, and just being around them and being around superfast girls definitely pushes me a lot harder in races, so that's how I get faster, I guess.
909 for 3200 on the track this season after winning his county and sectional championship.
Is that a gear that you're in? Is that a brand new gear that you just found today, or is that normal for you?
I think that was my strategy for the past couple of races. I knew I had a little bit of that kick, and I've been practicing it on my races, and it's worked out pretty well for me. I knew she could catch me because she's an absolutely amazing runner, but I thought that I would just not think about that and just give it my best. This is my race, too.
Was this race as hard as the NXR Midwest one where you had to deal with Kaylin at the end of that?
That was really difficult for me as well, because it was sort of that same pressure, knowing that she's right behind me. She's an amazing runner, she can catch me, but I was just trying to forget about that and run my own race and get to that finish line.
All this racing, all this traveling, what's next for you now? Some downtime or something else?
Finally some downtime. It was absolutely really sad for me that this was my last high school cross country race, but I'm also happy to be finished because this season has been really long, and I'm happy that I'll have a little bit of time off before last year. Start it ran 4:13 for